Shall I find a tape?
No, if there's a tape already in the machine, I'd like to hear that.
It's something I've been listening to a lot lately. Though it's not an entirely complete recording, unfortunately.
What is it?
It's Bach. From his little organ book. Ich rufe zu dir, Jesu Christ. The theme is originally a hymn. Bach rearranged it and embellished it a little. He was the master of polyphony, if you know what that is.
No, yet another thing I don't know.
But polyphony is, from the Middle Ages, it's an entirely European phenomenon. It's distinguished by the idea that every voice is its own melody, but together in harmony. Bach's forerunner, Palestrina, he wrote many works for several choirs at the same time, wallowing in polyphony. But in my eyes, Bach perfected the melodic expression and the harmony. And also mixed up with some rather incomprehensible mystique regarding numbers, most likely based on the Fibonacci sequence. You know, the one that starts with the zero and then comes the one. The sequence is created by adding the two previous numbers to create the new one. So it's zero plus one makes one, and one plus one makes two, and two plus one makes three, and three plus two makes five, and five plus three makes eight, and eight plus five makes 13. The sequence has an interesting connection to Pythagoras' theorem and the golden section. It was all about finding a divine methodology in art and architecture. A bit like the way tritone, which was played on the piano in your little club, was supposed to be a satanic interval. The sum of the numeric values represented in Bach's name is 14, a number he often used in his compositions. The clever thing about Bach's name is that the numeric value of the individual letters are all Fibonacci numbers. This piece has three voices.
A bass voice? The second voice played with the left hand. The first voice played with the right hand. That is called cantus firmus or cantus firmus. And together, these three voices create the polyphony.